We're given f of x equals 2x minus 3, and g of x equals 3x squared plus 5x plus 1. We want to determine each of the following. We first have f of 2 plus g of negative 2. To find f of 2, we want to find the output of function f when the input is 2. To do this, we'll substitute 2 for x in function f. To find g of negative 2, we want to find the output of function g when the input is negative 2, which means we'll substitute negative 2 for x in function g. So for f of 2, we would have 2 times 2 minus 3, and then plus g of negative 2, which would be 3 times negative 2 squared plus 5 times negative 2 plus 1. So f of 2 would be 4 minus 3, that's 1, plus g of negative 2. Negative 2 squared is positive 4 times 3 is 12. And then plus negative 10, or just minus 10, plus 1. So we have positive 1 plus 12 minus 10 plus 1 is 3. 1 plus 3 equals 4. So f of 2 plus g of negative 2 equals 4. Next we have g of 6 minus f of negative 3. Notice here function g is first and function f is second. So to find g of 6, we'll substitute 6 for x in function g. And to find f of negative 3, we'll substitute negative 3 for x in function f. So for g of 6, we'd have 3 times 6 squared plus 5 times 6 plus 1. And then we have minus f of negative 3, which would be 2 times negative 3 minus 3. It is important that we have each function value in parentheses so that we make sure that we add or subtract the entire function value. So for g of 6, 6 squared is 36. 36 times 3 is 108. Plus 30 plus 1. And then minus f of negative 3. This would be negative 6 minus 3, or negative 9. So here we have 108 plus 30 plus 1. That's going to be 139. Here we have minus negative 9, or plus positive 9, which is 148. G of 6 minus f of negative 3 equals 148. Next we have f of 4 times g of 1. So to find f of 4, we'll substitute 4 for x in function f. And to find g of 1, we'll substitute 1 for x in function g. And then we'll find this product. So for f of 4, we'd have 2 times 4 minus 3 times g of 1, which would be 3 times 1 squared plus 5 times 1 plus 1. So f of 4 is 8 minus 3, or 5. And g of 1 would be 1 squared is 1, 1 times 3 is 3. So if 3 plus 5, that's 8, plus 1 is 9. And 5 times 9 is 45. So f of 4 times g of 1 equals 45. And now for the last example, we have g of 9 divided by f of 10. So we'll substitute 9 into function g, and we'll substitute 10 into function f, and then find this quotient. So for g of 9, we would have 3 times 9 squared plus 5 times 9 plus 1. And for f of 10, we would have 2 times 10 minus 3. So 9 squared is 81. 81 times 3 is 243. 9 times 5 is 45, so plus 45 plus 1. And 2 times 10 is 20, minus 3 is 17. 243 plus 45 plus 1 equals 289. And our denominator is 17. And 17 is a factor of 289. 289 is equal to 17 times 17. So we can see the 17 over 17 simplifies to 1. And therefore, this is equal to 17. G of 9 divided by F of 10 equals 17. I hope you found this helpful.